good day. I'm Samantha Allen, and this is your GIS News for Thursday, February 13. Jamaicans and potential investors are being assured that the country's financial system remains strong amidst austerity measures on the government's economic reform program. Finance Minister Dr. Peter Phillips gave that assurance on Wednesday at a forum hosted by the Department of Economics at the University of the West Indies, Mona.
There is no reason to have any suspicion about the integrity and the financial stability of any of the institutions. Our regulatory environment is sound. Our regulatory standards, in fact, exceed those in the Basel III standards and provisions. And we are confident in the stability and sustainability of the financial system.
Dr. Phillips added that prior to the national debt exchange, the banking sector was subject to extensive stress testing from local and international interests. In addition, liquidity support for banks that encountered problems following the debt exchange remains untouched. The finance minister also asserted that legislative changes to the Omnibus Banking and Financial Securities Acts would give the Bank of Jamaica added powers to govern and strengthen the banking sector. Meanwhile, the Development Bank of Jamaica is on track to roll out its venture capital fund later this year. Minister Phillips says the aim is to provide capital for those entrepreneurs with good ideas.
It's going to be accomplished in two ways, really, and we have sought in many ways to do it. It's going to be accomplished through venture funds and the like. It's going to be accomplished by maintaining fiscal prudence, which will ensure that there are none of these spikes in unforeseen spikes and crises as far as interest rates are concerned.
Legislative amendments to the Securities Interest in Personal Property Act should also facilitate more access to funds for developing small businesses. The Agriculture Ministry has disbursed more than $10 million in grants to help exporters improve their operations and meet the requirements of the United States Food Safety Modernization Act. Following a tour of two export facilities in Western Jamaica recently, Agriculture and Fisheries Minister Roger Clark said he was very pleased with the resulting improvements.
Our commitment is to do whatever we can to make sure that we achieve the food safety standards necessary not only for exports, but to make our people aware of what food safety means. And we are well on our way, and I think we have some very cooperative people working with, and I think we will achieve what we have set out to achieve.
Minister Clark said the number of operators benefiting from the assistance will be extended from 7 to 24 during the course of the year. Victor Wright of Supreme Quality Exports in Frome, Westmoreland speaks highly of the program. Children in at least one state care facility will soon be in a better position to transition to adulthood following the full implementation of the Homestead Independent Living Project. Under the project, a cottage at the Homestead Place of Safety in Stony Hill, St. Andrew, is being refurbished to provide an avenue for the girls to take care of themselves. Among other things, the girls will be taught computer and vocational skills such as cosmetology to provide them with the expertise necessary to obtain or create jobs. Through a $4 million donation from the British High Commission, the Rotary Club of St. Andrew will be partnering with the Child Development Agency, the CDA, to refurbish and retrofit the building with appropriate tools. Youth Minister Lisa Hanna thanked the organizations for partnering with the CDA, adding that it fitted into government's mandate to provide additional support to children in state care.
We have been on a very strategic objective to not only ensure that we take care of our children in state care, but that we also ensure that there's a transition mechanism for girls and boys, and that they feel comfortable both emotionally and physically to go out there into the world of work and to live on their own and be independent.
The Homestead Place of Safety currently provides support to 61 girls aged 13 to 18 years in need of care and protection. And finally, government has planned a series of public consultations to provide information on the Climate Change Framework Policy and Action Plan, the Green Paper for which was tabled in Parliament last year. The consultations are being implemented by the Climate Change Division in the Ministry of Water, Land, Environment and Climate Change. They'll be held in four key parishes: St. Mary on February 14, St. Elizabeth on the 18th, and St. James and Kingston on the 19th. The consultations will be specifically targeted at farmers, fisherfolk, business owners and non-governmental organizations. And that's it for JIS News today. I'm Samantha Allen. Thanks for watching.